today, God. Thank you, Lord, for your amazing grace.
Oh, Majesty, hey, how we bless you. For you alone are worthy of my praise. Can we sing that softly, everybody? Ooh, Majesty. Worship Majesty, how I bless you, for you alone are worthy of my praise.
Raise your voice
and Majesty, how I worship Majesty,
how I bless you,
how I bless you,
for you,
for you alone.
Sing it again, everybody.
Majesty, how I worship Majesty, how I bless you,
for you,
for you alone are worthy of my praise.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. Father in heaven, you are worthy of our praise on today. Father, we just praise and thank you for your amazing grace. Lord, we thank you for your loving kindness. Thank you for your tender mercy. We bless you on this morning as we assemble ourselves in the house of the Lord. We praise you for just another day. Thank you for forgiving us for all of our sins. Thank you, Lord, for blotting out all of our transgressions. Thank you for creating in us a clean heart and renewing in us a right spirit. Have your way on today. Move by your spirit, God. Let your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. We praise you, Lord God, for every man, woman, boy, and girl. In the name of Jesus, we pray for them, Lord God, that has not chosen you as Savior. We pray, Father, oh God, that they'll hear your word, that they'll humble their heart, that they'll cry out to you, for you are worthy of praise, glory, and honor. You are our Father. Oh God, thank you for your love. Thank you for your mercy. Thank you for sending your only Son to die on Calvary's cross for each and every one of us. We praise you right now, Lord. Have thine own way. We welcome your presence. We welcome your power. We welcome your anointing. Oh, Lord God, thank you for your word on today. Thank you for using your man servant for your glory. Thank you for stirring up our Messiah, your Holy Spirit that is within us. We give you glory. Oh, Lord, as we stir up the gift of God, we thank you right now. Oh, God, we ask that we decrease while your Holy Spirit increase. Oh, God, take over our voices. Take over our praise. Have thine own way. Let thine will be done, that you may be magnified in all the earth. And we won't fail to honor you, bless you, and give you all of the praise. In Jesus' name, amen.
We bless your name, God.
Thank you, Lord God.
again. Majesty,
majesty.
Come on, everybody.
How I bless you.
Majesty,
majesty. How I bless you.
For you alone.
For you alone. Are worthy of my praise.
Oh, for you are worthy.
You are worthy of my praise.
Somebody say, you are worthy.
You are worthy of my praise.
Oh, you are worthy.
You are worthy of my
praise. Oh, you are worthy.
You are worthy of my praise.
Reach to heaven and say, you are worthy.
You are worthy of my praise. You are worthy of my praise.
We bless your name, God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. We give your name the praise, God. Oh, we bless your name, God.
Glory to your name, Jesus. Oh, bless your name, Jesus.
This ain't no ordinary worship.
Woo, glory, hallelujah.
This ain't no ordinary song. Yeah.
Oh, yes, God.
The God of service greater than the ordinary.
Oh, yeah.
Gonna give it all I have in this moment. Come on, help me sing, y'all.
This ain't no ordinary worship.
No, this ain't no ordinary.
This ain't no ordinary song.
No, no, no. Is greater.
The God I serve is greater than the ordinary.
Gonna give it all I have.
Gonna give it all I have in this moment.
Oh, oh, oh.
Ooh.
Let me tell a story about a woman with an issue. She had it 12 years. She didn't know what to do. Oh, yeah. She heard about a man coming through her town. She fell to her knees and she crawled on the ground. Oh, yes, she did. This is what she said, y'all. She said, if I can only hold the hem of his garment, gonna give it all I have in this moment. Come on, help me sing, y'all.
This ain't no ordinary worse.
No, it ain't, no, it ain't, no, it ain't, no, it ain't.
This ain't no ordinary song.
No, 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 no. no, no.
The God I serve is greater than the ordinary.
So I'm gonna give it all I have.
I'm gonna give him all I have in this song.
Let me tell you about a story about a man from Galilee. Whoa. He healed the lame, caused the blind to see. This man was betrayed, crucified for you and me.
Oh, oh, oh.
This man only wanted to make us free. Oh, yes, he did.
Oh, yes, he did.
Oh, 'cause in 3 days he rose with all power.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
In 3 days he rose with all power.
Yeah.
In 3 days he rose with all power. Come on, help me sing, y'all.
This ain't no ordinary worship.
No, this ain't no ordinary.
This ain't no ordinary.
No, 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 no. The God I serve is greater.
The God I serve is greater than the ordinary.
Gonna give it all I have.
I'm gonna give it all I have.
Worship. Come on, help me sing it, y'all.
This ain't no ordinary song.
No, it ain't. No, it ain't. No, it ain't.
The God I serve is greater than the ordinary. Gonna give it all I have in this moment.
Ordinary
words.
No, this ain't no ordinary song.
This ain't no ordinary song.
Oh, no. The God I serve is greater.
The God I serve is greater than the ordinary.
So I'm gonna give it all I have.
I'm gonna give him all I have. No ordinary worship.
No, it ain't, no, it ain't, no, it ain't.
This ain't no ordinary song.
No, 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 no. The God I serve is greater.
The God I serve is greater than the ordinary. Gonna give it all I have in this moment.
All you have in this moment. I woke up grateful this morning. I woke up thankful this morning. I woke up with my mind on the Lord this morning, because this ain't no ordinary worship. Oh, it's not an ordinary song. Oh, can we sing it one more time, y'all?
Come on, help me sing, y'all.
This ain't no ordinary words.
No, it ain't, no, it ain't, no, it ain't.
This ain't no ordinary song.
No, 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 no. The God I serve is greater.
The God I serve is greater than the ordinary.
So I'm gonna give it all I have.
So I'm gonna give him all I have in this moment.
Let me tell you. tell a story about the woman with an issue. Oh yeah, she healed. You know what to do. Yeah, she heard about a man coming through her town. She fell to her knees and crawled on the ground. Oh yes she did. This is what she said, y'all. She said, if I can only touch the hem of his garment, gonna give it all I have in this moment. Come on, help me sing, y'all.
This ain't no ordinary birth.
No, this ain't no ordinary.
This ain't no ordinary song.
No, no, no. The God I serve is greater.
The God I serve is greater than the ordinary. So I'm going to give him all I have in this moment.
Let me tell a story about a man from Galilee. Oh yeah, he healed the lame, caused the blind to see.
See.
This man was betrayed, crucified for you and me.
Oh, oh, oh.
This man only wanted to make us free. Oh yes he did.
Oh yes he did.
Oh, 'cause in 3 days he rose with all power.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
In 3 days he rose with all power. In 3 days he rose with all power.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Gonna give it all I have. Gonna give it all I have. Gonna give it all I have in this moment. Come on, help me sing, y'all.
This ain't no ordinary words.
No, it ain't, no, it ain't, no, it ain't, no, it ain't.
This ain't no ordinary song.
No, 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 no. The God I serve is greater.
The God I serve is greater than the ordinary. So I'm gonna give him all I have in this moment.
Somebody say, play it, Robin, play it, Robin.
Woo!
Amen. Good morning, God of Deliverance family.
Morning.
Amen. Good morning, Facebook family. And to all those that are listening, have a listening ear on this morning. Amen. God has shown himself faithful.
Yes.
And he has shown himself mighty and strong.
Yes.
Do I have at least one or two witnesses?
Oh, yes.
That God has been faithful.
Yes.
And it recalls to my mind, amen, what the man of God has given us, what God has given him to give to us in 2020, that I see you. Yeah. I don't know about you, but I do know about you, that because you're here, You always are saying, God, I see you in every situation.
Yes.
That I see or come against every day. God, I see you. I have seen you as a protector. I have seen you as a giver.
Amen.
I have seen you as a keeper. I have seen you as a way maker.
Yes.
Yes.
Amen. And God, you have proven yourself time and time again. Do I have a witness there?
Amen. Yes.
Amen. Amen. What a mighty God we serve.
Yes.
Angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adore him. What a mighty God we serve. Do I have a witness there?
Amen. Yes. Amen.
Amen. I'm standing before you to say that God has been good to me.
Yes. Yes.
And we must take that personal, that God has been good to us.
Yes.
In spite of the pandemic, God has been good to us.
Yes.
Not to say that we're no better than anybody else, but we all have our own personal testimony of what God has done for us in the midst of 2020. Amen. I tell you, I have peace in my mind and in my heart on today that God is going to continue to take care of us.
Yes.
To the end of the year.
Amen.
That's his word. I'll never leave you nor forsake you.
That's what he said.
Is that his word?
That's what he said.
Is that his word?
Yes.
Amen. So today, amen, I'm standing before you. Amen. Giving you this opportunity to give to God of Deliverance Ministries. On behalf of Apostle Kenneth Anderson, on behalf of Pastor Janice Anderson, and the entire God of Deliverance family, we want to tell you personally, thank you, thank you, thank you for what you have given down throughout this year. You have blessed our hearts gratefully. You have blessed our hearts graciously. And we just want to take time to say thank you for what you have done for us.
Yes.
It has been a blessing to us, amen, to keep going forth, to be a blessing to those across the America, across the nation, across the world.
Amen.
And we give you praise. God, can you give them a hand, amen, for what they've done for us,
amen,
to help us,
amen,
to continue on this great gospel of Jesus Christ. Amen. We give you the opportunity to give it to us as you begin to see on the screen, as they begin to put it up, different avenues, amen, of ways to give unto God of Deliverance. Amen. You have the God of Deliverance app. You have the, amen, the post office way, post office box. I believe that's 1058. Amen. Rocky Mountain, North Carolina. My eyes are blurry right now, so y'all excuse me. It's not of age. Glory to God. Amen. We've also got PayPal. Amen. And we got Cash App. Amen. $ God of Dale. Amen. So I leave the scripture with you, and I'm going to get out the way. This I recall to my mind, therefore I have hope. It is of the Lord's mercies that we are not consumed. His compassion faileth not, and they are new every morning and every day and every night. And great is thou faithfulness. If you believe that, put your hand together and give God praise. Amen. We're now back in the hand, amen, of the praise team.
Lord, we thank you.
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 you.
Lord, we thank you.
Lord,
this is the way to sing praises to my Lord.
Lord, we thank you.
Lord, we thank you.
Somebody said thank you.
Lord, we 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 thank you. This is the way to sing praises to my Lord.
You've been a mother.
You've been a mother.
You've been a father.
You've been a father.
You've been a sister.
You've been a sister.
And a brother.
And a brother.
This is
the way to sing praises to my Lord.
This is
the way to sing praises to my Lord.
Lord, we thank you.
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 This is
the way to sing praises to our Lord.
You've been a mother.
You've been a mother.
You've been a father.
You've been a
brother.
You've been a brother.
Lord, we thank you.
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 Come on, say thank you.
Lord, we thank you.
If you thank you.
Lord, we thank you.
If your boss has said thank
you. Lord, we thank you.
God, thank you, Lord.
Lord, we thank you.
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 This is
the way we sing praises to our Lord. This is the way we sing praises to our Lord.
Put your hands together.
Come on, give God praise. Ah, yeah. Lord, we thank you. Woo! Yeah. We thank you. It
If you got a praise, you ought to give it to him. If you got a thank you, Jesus, you ought to give it to him. If you still got a hallelujah left, you ought to give it to him. If you got a praise ye the Lord, you ought to give it to him. If you got a I thank you, Lord, you ought to give it to him. Hallelujah! Woo! I come prepared to give him glory and to give him honor. You ought not to come just empty-minded and empty-headed. You ought to come prepared to give God the glory. Look at your neighbor and just tell him, I got something to thank the Lord for. He's been mighty good. Can you testify and tell somebody? He's been mighty good to me. As the preacher said earlier, my eyes might be a little cloudy, but it ain't from age. I still can see clearly now that I need the Lord. Come on, give God a praise. Ah, yes. Oh, yeah, yeah, yes. I come to bless him. Early on this Sunday morning, I'm still not tired of praising him yet. I wish I had a concert in here. I wish I had a few folk in here that don't mind saying, Lord, I'm here to give you all the glory. I come with one purpose. I come to magnify him. And I heard David cry out and said, oh, magnify the Lord with me. And let us exalt his name together. Do I have any exalters in the building? I got something to praise him for. He healed me when I was sick. He helped me when I couldn't help myself. Oh, magnify. Hey, God. I come to magnify. I come to make him big in my mind. I come to make him big in my sight. That's why David said, oh, 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 magnify. Look at your neighbor, say, neighbor, you got to make the Lord big. Big in your mind. Big in your dream. Big in your hope. Big in your imagination. Whoa! You got to make him big. Look at your neighbor, say, neighbor, you got to make him big. You got to make him awesome. Woo! Oh! Tell your neighbor, I'm making God bigger than my problem. I'm making God bigger than my circumstance. Oh, magnify. Tell your neighbor, you got to make them bigger than that. Oh! I don't know about you, but that makes me feel good when I say, oh! Woo! Tell somebody, you got to make them bigger than that. I don't have room to complain because I done made God bigger than that. Oh, I wish I could get a witness. You got to make God bigger than that. Come on, just tell three people. Tell them on Facebook. Tell them on Zoom. You got to make God bigger than that. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. I hear David in the spirit right now. Said, if I could just get some people to magnify him with me, I believe we can come out together. You won't just get your victory, but that one over there will get their victory. And not only will you get your victory, but you'll get your victory too. If we can just magnify him together. Woo! Whoa! Woo! I could stay right there all day. Come on, smile at somebody behind that mask and tell them you got to make God bigger than that. Woo, I was getting ready to complain till I realized once I magnified him, he became bigger than that. Woo! I'm making God bigger than that. The devil want to try to give me a reason to complain, but I'm making God bigger than that. Is the Holy Ghost talking to anybody yet? And my God, who is able to do exceedingly and abundantly and above all I can think or ask. You got to realize you got to make, magnify. My. I remember when I was young and we would be playing tops. Some of y'all don't even know what that is. We would be out there playing tops. Then when we would get kind of bored, I don't know if some of y'all did it. We were kind of cruel being young. We get the magnifying glass and find us some ants and burn up the ants with the sun shining because we done magnified the rays of the sun against the ants. And God is saying, if you would magnify me like that, I'll burn up your problem. I'll burn up your circumstance. I'll burn up the situation. If you just learn how to magnify me on the problem, I can take care of the problem. But you got to learn how to magnify me while you're on the problem, and I'll make it dissipate and disappear. But you got to learn how to magnify. Well, I'm trying to calm down, but guess what? When God give you an answer to a problem, you ought to get excited about it. Can I get a hallelujah out there somewhere? Woo! And we would get excited about the effect of the power of the sun. That you could make something burn up. You would get excited about your problems burning right up in the midst of your face. Huh? When you learn how to magnify. Because our God is a consuming fire. Who can stand against the awesomeness of the God in whom you serve? You ought to just give him a free praise on that. That's a free praise, Lord. Somebody ought to break out and just say, hallelujah. That's just a free praise, Lord. Because when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all that he had. Look. This is me magnifying before he even gets finished. Thanking him for what he's already done. Ask your neighbor, has God done anything for you? Sometimes you got to praise him on your leftovers. Tell your neighbor, this is a praise on my leftovers. I'm still remembering what he's already done. Can I get a praise in the building? Woo! I'm praising him for what he's already done. Woo! All right, Robin Mike. Y'all get off the instruments. Y'all get off the instruments, cause I'm not gonna calm down. And I need the energy to finish this, cause we even got communion today. I'm getting ready to be 65 years old. I'm jumping out here like I'm 17. And they helping me right along. But then when I keep on going, they're gonna be sitting over there looking at me. Somebody say amen. But it's exciting to be around excitable folk who are excitable about serving God. And it don't take a whole lot to pump you up.
because you come here already pumped up. You ain't bringing wet wood. You bringing dry wood so you can catch on fire. Ah, somebody ought to say there's a blessing in the house. Ah, come on, give God a good hand clap. Hallelujah. Amen. Catch on fire. Somebody ought to call the fire department. They said, why? Because there's a man in there on fire. There's a woman in there on fire. Amen. Look at your neighbor and say, he talking about you now. He talking about you. I wish somebody so would catch on fire. Catch on fire. Catch on fire. I said, I wish somebody so would help me up. Burning with the Holy Ghost. Woo! Wish somebody so would catch on fire. Catch on fire. So would. Cut a mic on, Joyce. With the Holy Ghost. Woo! Somebody say, I wish somebody's soul would catch on fire. Catch on fire. Burn with the Holy Ghost. One more time. Oh. Woo! I wish somebody's soul. Now, if you see her mic ain't working, grab a mic and handle one. Come on, somebody help me. Amen. Never mind, too late. Somebody say, praise the Lord. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. Wish somebody so would catch on fire. Burning with the Holy Ghost. I want to encourage somebody. You might be in the building. You might be on Facebook. You might be on YouTube, you might be on Zoom. I don't know where you're at. But somebody need to be encouraged to know if you magnify him. God said, I'll be a consuming fire. I'll burn it up for you. Because that's the kind of God we serve. Amen. Woo! Well, let's get to the text. Hallelujah. My theme thought for this holiday service, because we will not be having service on Christmas Day. I may just give a shout out on Christmas Day on Facebook. But we'll be here Sunday after Christmas. Amen. Preaching and sharing the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. What you saying over there? Okay, what does that got to do with what I'm talking about? But anyway. She's talking to me, interrupting my train of thought, and I be picking up her waves, you know. And she is my wife, so that's why I be acknowledging her. Amen. A wife of 45 years, so I know to listen. I ain't got to try to figure it out, just listen. Amen. Anybody been married for any length of time, all of us men know, just listen. Amen. They don't want you fixing everything. They just want you to listen. Amen. It takes time for us men to gravitate, to understand we can't fix everything. But if we just listen, sometimes that's just good enough. Amen. Amen. Somebody say, you've been married 45 years? I say, yep. Been married 45 years, and I've always got the last word. They say, what is that? Yes, dear. And you'll be married 45 years. Amen to the Lord. Somebody say amen. But I want to use amen on this great afternoon, morning. Amen. I'm coming prepared. When we come to church, we ought to come with some form of preparation. You ought not to come to service, or because of this pandemic, sitting in front of the videos or whatever that you may be tuning into your Sunday broadcast with. You ought not to come just to be coming, but you ought to be coming with some form of expectation, not hoping and missing, but believing. For we walk by faith and not by sight. And sometimes what we see will cause us frustration because we're too attached to the natural. But see, the natural can fool you and make you think that the natural is stronger than your expectation. And I don't know about you, but I expect to win in any situation that I find myself in. Can I get a witness in here? I don't care what kind of situation that has been derived or designed to come and approach me or attack me or defeat me, I've already realized that God has given me a guarantee of victory. He has already said that I am a more than a conqueror. I look at your neighbor and say, you ought to act like it if you believe it. If I'm going to ask you to pray, I am going to ask you, amen, to save the lost. But as for the situation, it's already taken care of. Can you tell somebody it's already taken care of? And because of this here Christmas holiday that we are approaching, amen, it behooves us to try to remind what Christmas is really all about. It is not about just presents that you exchange one from another. It is the most desperate time because this is a high rate of suicide, high rate of depression, a high rate, amen, of arguments and fights. Why? Because of the pressures that people put on one another because of a holiday. People have flashbacks of loved ones departing, and there's so many different things that comes upon the minds of those during holiday seasons. But if we would keep Christ in our minds, Jesus, the birth of his life coming upon the earth, if we could think about biblical principles of the holiday, we would have, amen, a more positive view of our situation. Santa Claus is too big to slide down the chimney. He's just an idea trying to take away the glory away from God. And if you still believe in Santa Claus and your little ones are listening, please put it on silent till I finish talking about them. And then you can continue to lie to your children. But Christmas is all about the birth of Jesus Christ. It's about Jesus. You ought to just post it up there somewhere and tell them Christmas is about Jesus. Now, what people want to do is argue about the date. Well, I'm so glad to know that I'm not concerned about the date. I'm just concerned that he was born. You can pick January 5th. You can pick December. You can pick whatever month you want. But I'm just glad he showed up. I'm glad he fulfilled what was spoken in the garden, that he would bruise the head of the serpent and the serpent would bruise his heel. I'm so glad that he showed up. You got all these that will get caught up in the genealogies, even though the Bible says don't allow yourself to get caught up in all that mess. Because who is the only one that can keep an accurate record? And that is the Lord. He watches over his own work. Well, you know, the Bible is written by man. Well, every book you've ever read in your entire life is written by some human. But the difference is, through the inspiration of the Holy Ghost, was the Word of God printed. I wish I could get somebody to say hallelujah, amen. And so therefore, with all the skeptics, with all the doubters, you go on and have your sinner party. But as for me and my house, we have learned to serve the Lord. Come on, give God a praise. I come prepared. Come on, tell your neighbor, I come prepared. And that's what we must always do, amen, when we're in the front of folk who don't want to believe. Always have a problem with your walk with God. Let me tell you something. There's flawed people, but don't let their flaws interfere with your lifestyle. And for all of you that want everybody to love you, I might as well go on and preach your funeral, because you're going to die dissatisfied. When Jesus said, if they hate me, they're going to hate you too. When you stand up for what is right in the midst of wrong generational folk, you can expect kind of attitudes. But let me understand, let me help you understand something. Everybody in your life is nothing but a thermostat. What do you mean, preacher? You control the temperature and not them. I wish I could get a hallelujah in the building. When you learn to stop letting them make you a thermostat and control your attitude, you're going to be a better person. Come on, somebody. We done got so fancy with technology, I can be here in this building and change the temperature in my house because it's now Wi-Fi, and I can be in another location and control them. What are you talking about? If I pray before I get to where I got to go and there's problems, I can set the temperature before I get there. Are you hearing what I'm saying? You got to come prepared. You got to come in. Prepare for any environment that you know you're going to go into. If it's a hostile environment, go in there prepared. You don't go down to the beach when it's 10 degrees and you coming out there talking about, I'm prepared to go swimming. You prepared to get in the pneumonia and you prepared to die. What are you talking about, preacher? Because you're coming into an environment unprepared. So if I know that I'm going into an environment, amen, that may not be so friendly, you ought to leave your emotions in your closet. If you're coming into a loving environment, you ought to come prepared for that too. Because there's somebody, you ought to look at your neighbor and say, there's somebody that loves you. And that's who you need to spend time thinking on. For whoever needed that. But my focus today is I'm coming prepared. Father, we thank you for this opportunity of being able to stand before so great cloud of witnesses. I pray that this word will not just fall on deaf ears. I pray that somebody who stands in need and desires a fresh revelation, a brand new start, will hear this word and be motivated and prompt by the Holy Ghost to make better choices for their lives and become strength to their spiritual man. I pray healing on the sick even now. We thank you for the vaccine, but most of all, we thank you for the blood. We thank you for the blood that can heal, deliver, and set free. And so, God, we thank you for this moment of being able to share your glorious gospel with those who would want to hear the truth. In Jesus' name, somebody say amen. Amen. Open up your Bibles to the book of Matthew, chapter 1. And the Bible says, now when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem. Somebody say wise men. Wise men serve God. Wise men. This term is translated from the word wise men from the word magi. Magi means, amen, this was a priestly order. These were men who had special gifts. They were gifted in astrology. They were gifted in studying the stars. What is that word they use, the people that study those star things? Who? Astrologists. Who? There's another name they be using out here, the zodiac signs and all that. What do they call them? That's the same thing. Well, anyway, they studied all that. They were being able to see the stars and say what this one mean and what that one mean. But when God has a purpose, when God wants to change your life, he'll use whatever means necessary to get your attention, and he will speak in your language. Are you hearing what I'm saying? If you were back in those days, we could see how that God spoke to these wise men through the stars because he knew that they studied those particular things.
But you also look in the book of Luke, you'll see that God wants to talk to the shepherds. He came to them and talked to them through an angel. God will use circumstances and situations to talk to us in whatever language you speak. The Bible says that when the Holy Ghost came upon them in the upper room, how every man heard in their own language. So God is always trying to draw us to himself, because all of us have a divine purpose from God. You were not created just to exist. You were created by God with a purpose. And so these men were not just ordinary men. You ought to look at your neighbor and say, you're not ordinary. Especially now that you done gave God your life, you're not ordinary. You are peculiar. Now look at your neighbor and say, stop trying to figure me out. I'm too peculiar for that. If you can't figure out God, you'll never figure me out. Come on, tell somebody. And so these men were not ordinary men. The Bible goes on to let us know that because of Daniel, amen, Daniel was the cause of this priestly group of people rising up. What do you mean, preacher? The Bible says, amen, in Daniel chapter 2, verse 48, it says, then the king made Daniel, God's man. Somebody say, God's man. A great man. Now, I want to step back just for a second. For all of you that are facing trials in your life, stop running and start standing. Because whenever you are victorious over a trial, there is a promotion. And I've not noticed any in the Bible being elevated without a trial. Now look at your neighbor and said, if you just look at things differently, you'll get a different attitude. They're not trying to stop you. They're not trying to hold you back. God's trying to get them saved. So we see here, because of Daniel, the great man, it says, and gave him many gifts. What? Gave him what? Many gifts, and made him ruler over the whole province of Babylon. Now, I need you to understand, this is a slave. A slave goes from being enslaved to being in control, becoming into power, to stand in authority. He didn't let his past hinder his future. Stop using your past as an excuse to be a failure. God can do anything with anybody that will give him any time. Can I talk to somebody? And here he is now, placed over a province of men and chief of the governors over what? All the wise men of Babylon. Now you need to understand something about this story. You need to understand that now that he is the head honcho, he can now teach about the coming of the Messiah. And so these wise men over the generation of time have come to understand that David was talking about a Messiah soon coming. And even though they were still studying the stars, they never forgot what Daniel taught the generation. I'm saddened by this generation of people, because this is a generation that's raising another generation without the fear of God. And so there will not be really no divine leadership in their life pertaining to the Lord. And when you don't have, amen, a foundation or a structure, amen, based on the Lord God himself, then the enemy can lead you anywhere. And so we see here that Daniel began to teach them and to share with them because he was over them. Good God Almighty. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, there can be people that can be over you. But if you stand with God, tell them, if you stand with God, one day you'll be in charge. Come on, give God a good hand clap. The Bible indicates to us that because of this teaching, amen, you got to understand the region. They came from the east, which indicated that they were Arabians or they were Persian people. They were people of color. Let me say that again. They were people of color. There is a big upheaval going on in Christendom right now because we as people of color have now come to understand that if you want to know black history, read the Bible. Oh, I wish I could talk to somebody. We have been under the illusion that everybody in the Bible were white. But now because we have educated ourselves, and now because we have learned how to read, we have come to understand that if you want to know anything about black history, you ought to read the Bible. When they talk about Abraham, they're not talking about a Caucasian. And I'm not pushing out prejudice. I'm just pushing out understanding and wisdom. We are in the book. Come on, give God a good praise and say, we are in the book. So my focus is on today three particular areas of this story. Number one, they came prepared for the journey. When you came and gave your life to Christ, you ought to be prepared for the journey. This is not an overnight work. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, you see me now. But you didn't see when I started. It's been a journey just to get here. I may not be everything you think I ought to be, but there's been a journey to get right here. And guess what? If you hold my mule, I'll shout right now because you don't know my story. Everything I've gone through, there was a journey involved. There were some tears involved. There was some setback involved. But through the grace of God, I am. So when you see me throw up my hand and begin to worship God, you don't know my story. I got a reason for my praise. You ought to tell somebody right there, I got a reason for my praise. These wise men were prepared for the journey. What do you mean, preacher? First of all, I want to remind you, this was no ordinary journey. Come on, tell somebody, you're not on an ordinary journey. That's why you got so many obstacles always seem to pop up out of nowhere. I wish I was talking to somebody that had been through something. Huh? Unexpected stuff just pop up out of nowhere. You know why? Because your enemy and mine know that we are on the road to success. That's why he's trying to make you quit. Anybody ever felt like quitting? But your praise got you through. I don't know about you. Tell your neighbor, if it wasn't for my praise, I don't think I could. Woo! I'm happy tonight. Woo! Look at this. So we see here that because they were invited. Isn't it amazing? They were invited. A star invited them on this journey. And with understanding that there was a divine intervention in this invitation, they start preparing for their journey. What do you mean, preacher? Look at what the Bible says. The Bible says in Matthew 2:2, saying, where is he that is born king of the Jews? For we have what? Seen his star in the east. And guess what? We came prepared. Did you come today prepared to worship God? Or did you come prepared for the leaders to try to make you worship God? They said, no, we had to count up the cost of this journey. Whew. What are you talking about, preacher? The Bible gives us an indication that they came from the east. And we read on like it was around the corner and they had a jaguar
or Impala to jump in ride in less than 10 minutes were there. But these magi's traveled from the east, mostly somewhere vastly around Mesopotamia, which was a range of maybe 400 to 700 miles, riding on camels, depending on the region. Amen. It could be a time frame from 40 days to 50 days to 60 days. I'm talking about traveling and walking tremendous terrain. They had to count up the cost. They had to know that this was not just some trip just to make. But because they were invited, good God Almighty, look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, when the Lord came into your life, you were invited to visit his kingdom and to handle his resources and to experience his presence. The journey is worth it. Oh, I wish I could get somebody to understand what. You ought to just tell somebody the journey is worth it. I've cried sometime, but the journey has been worth it. I didn't feel good sometime, but you know what? When I really look it over, I'm so glad to be on the Lord's side. I don't know about you, but I don't know what I would be like if God had not invited me in to the sonship of his son, that I could walk in the light as he is the light and have fellowship with him. Good God. So we must look at the determination. Tell your neighbor, how determined are you? Can anything make you quit? Sometimes I'd be tempted to ask church members, what would make you quit God of deliverance? Somebody's look? Somebody saying something crazy to you? Or are you locked in? Because when you come with the journey, you prepared. Good God Almighty. That'll preach right there. But these magi's were determined. Nothing was going to deter them from their quest, not even the threat of their lives. Whoa, anybody catch what I just said? I said, even with the threat of their lives. Why? Because they had invested so much. Whew. I want to stop right there just for a second. If you're not investing nothing in, it's easy for you to walk away. But whenever you have invested into something from your life, it's not easy to walk away. What are you talking about, preacher? Look at what the Bible says in Matthew. Matthew 2:1. Am I on the right slide? No, that's my note there. Amen. Say it again. Amen. Nothing. Somebody say nothing. It says here, so we must look at the destination of the determination of these magi's. What did it say? Nothing was going to deter them. Tell me, look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor, what will it take to stop you from your journey? You ought to get bad, bold, and bad enough to tell them there's nothing created yet that can make me ever stop. Come on, somebody. Come on, there's nothing created that can stop me on my journey now. What are you talking about, preacher? Look at what Matthew 2:1 says. Now, when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king. Now, you ought to stop right there. In the days of Herod the king. You think your situation bad? These magi's were known as kingmakers. That means that whenever they would show up, there was going to be a transition of power. Because there was going to be a new king on the rise. We got a glimpse of it in our political arena this year. How vicious it can become. But Herod would make our president look like a child in playing with tiddlywinks. Let's talk about this Herod. Herod was vicious and lustful. He had 9 wives. Are you hearing what I'm saying? He was so ruthless that he wouldn't hesitate to even kill up his own wife and some of his children. That's how ruthless he was. Are you hearing what I'm saying? He murdered them, and he was yet still called Herod the Great. He was called great by the secular world, but he wasn't great far as the biblical standpoint was. What are you talking about? He had no greatness of character, and he was great in vileness. And yet these wise men came into his presence and said, "Where is he?" Good God Almighty. You're talking about a bold, audacious people. They were so wise that they knew that they were coming in the presence of a vicious king. But guess what? They knew they served an awesome God. They knew that God invited them on this journey. Look at your neighbor and say, "Neighbor, no weapon." I wish somebody would start believing the word. No weapon. It looked like it formed against you, but it will not prosper. I wish I could tell it to you like that, but I'm so glad that God said it like that. But notice something. Come on, look with me. Notice something. Herod the king did not touch these magi because God was guiding them in their journey. Talk about me all you want, but you can't stop me. Ain't no stopping us now. We're on the move. Don't look at me cross-eyed. Tell your neighbor, we're on the move somewhere. And ain't nothing going to stop us. As long as we tagged in. Come on, tell them. Tagged in. Tag in. Come on, tell them. Tag in. Number two. Good God. First of all, I'm excited about the fact that they were invited by God. You didn't save yourself. Bible says no man can come unto him unless he draw them. You were invited to this thing. Tell your name. You were invited to this thing. You know how many times you almost gave up, but something on the inside, working on the outside. Oh, what a change. Come on, somebody. Number two. They prepared their gifts. Good God Almighty. They prepared their gifts. Tell your neighbor, neighbor, it's more than just money. See, the enemy wants you to focus in just on the money. Money plays a part, but that ain't the major focus here. The major focus is your heart. Come on, somebody. And so we see here that they were prepared to bring their gifts. Look at what the verse says. Verse 2 and 2. What does it say? It says saying, "Where is he?" Where is he? Now they standing in front of a vicious king and not intimidated. I don't know who I'm talking to right now. Maybe you're on Facebook. When you stand in front of your enemies, you can't stand there looking like a victim. You got to stand in such authority. I heard the deodorant commercial. Never let them see you sweat. They may be getting on your nerve, but you got a smile on your face. But behind that smile, they don't see that they about to get tore all to pieces. But by the grace of God, you smiling. Because you ain't letting them see that they're getting to you. See, people, when they know they can get to you, they'll keep on messing with you. But see, when you learn how to master your countenance. Old folk used to say, don't look at me in that tone of voice. See, your look will determine folk what folk will do with you. Oh, I wish I could talk to somebody. They standing in front of a vicious king and say, "Listen here, we know you're the king, but where is the other king?" Now, you got to be a bad somebody to stand in front of a man who will kill you at the drop of a hat and say to him, "We come to find your replacement." Y'all hearing anything out this word right now? Look at this. Look at it. So he said, "Listen, because guess what we did? Everybody knows that when they come, and get out your head, three men, they came with a caravan.
They came loaded down. They came with much more gifts than they usually would come, because they realized that this was a divine invitation. And so Eastern culture has always said, whenever you get ready to come in the presence of a king or someone prominent, you don't come empty-handed. I wish I could talk to somebody. So these magi's, who would usually be about 12, amen, during when you study the tradition, but here we find, amen, that they are in the presence of this king, and they ask, where is he? Because we have seen his star in the east, and we are come to worship. Now notice now, they have come to worship, but they came prepared with their gifts. Are you prepared to bring your gifts when you come in the presence of an almighty God? Or do you come that God might be your caretaker to give you everything you want? But see, they understood that they came to worship a God who was about to show them their king. Good God Almighty. I love the way, listen to this. I love the way God covers us. Tell your neighbor, tell three people, just tell three of them. Just tell them, God got you covered. Come on. I'm going to give you time to tell three people. Please, please make it at least three people. God got you covered. What do you mean, preacher? No, look at this. Look at this, man of God. It says that God led them by night and allowed a star to shine their path. What are you talking about, preacher? Sometimes you might be in the night, but God is going to always guide you out of the darkness. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Here, God would not let them labor in the heat of the sun, but would allow them to rest during the heat of the sun and let them travel in the breeze of the night. Good God Almighty. Tell you that God got you covered. So they were able to enjoy the evening of this, the day, and look at the stars at night with one star leading the way. Good God Almighty. A great heavenly host. What are you talking about, preacher? Let's read the scripture. I'm glad I got scripture, folk. Look at this. And the Bible says, and when they saw the star, they began to do what? Rejoice with exceeding great joy. Why such emphasis on their joy? It is because of the fact that they knew they were interrupted by a crazy king. Look at your neighbor, say, neighbor. Sometimes you'll have interruptions in life, but God got you covered. Look at what it says. It says, amen, in this verse, this next verse, it says here, and it says, and when they were come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary, his mother, and they did something. They fell down and worshiped him. They did what? Fell down and worshiped him. Huh? And then they did what? They began to open up their treasures, and they presented unto him gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, the gifts you offer is geared to your expectation. If you ain't giving, it is because you come with no expectation. If you are not giving, it is because you don't believe what the word of God says. Give and it shall be given unto you. Pressed down, shaken together. Listen here. They came prepared to give their all to Jesus. How about you? On this Christmas holiday season, are you worried about trying to have enough money to give gifts to everybody except Jesus? Well, you know Jesus ain't here. No, there's a ministry out there that represents the kingdom of God. What is it that you're going to do extra? Uh-oh, here we go.
Somebody done clicked me off already. Somebody done tuned out in the church. Come on, somebody. Get back. Come on back. Come on back. What are you going to do extra? Holding back nothing, they sold out and came prepared. They didn't come to critique or to criticize. They came prepared to give. God, what can I give out of me that you're trying to get out of me? Uh-oh. Anybody catch that? What's inside you that's not lining up with God that God says, I want you to give it to me? But I treasure this. I treasure my bad habits. I treasure my off spirit. No, God said, I want it. That's a gift that you've been attached to for so long that it has become precious to you. I want it. Give me that nasty attitude because it's almost like gold to you. Woo! Give me your disagreeable spirit because it's like silver to me. Come on, look at your neighbor as a neighbor. Yield up that frankincense. See, when you give God that worst out of you, he understands it's pearls to him, and then he gives you an exchange. He'll take out the stony heart and do what? Give you a heart of flesh. I wish I could talk to somebody. Catch the revelation. God said, bring it and give it to me. They came prepared to give whatever God wanted them to give up. Look at this. These gifts reflected their expectation. They were prepared to give it all to Jesus, holding back nothing. They didn't come to critique the journey. Listen to this now. Look at this. The journey was so precious that they refused to come empty. Are you hearing what I'm saying? When you have gone through a lot, you have gathered a lot. Can I talk to somebody? I want you to tell somebody right now, there's more inside of you than you'll ever imagine. Through all the experiences that you have faced, there's nothing but treasures on the inside of you. You got stories to tell. You got experiences to give. You got revelations to offer. You are a precious, you are a precious vessel that somebody's waiting to receive from you. Somebody ought to say hallelujah to the Lord. What are you talking about? This praise. Come on, can I mess with you one more time? Tell your neighbor. My praise has value to it. It came with a cause. You know me as a pastor, when I see people break out and start praising God, I'll stop preaching. Why? Because I know that if they dancing and shouting, they must have gotten victory over something. And my God, that shout is just a release. And guess what? I'm going to rejoice with those that rejoice. I'll tell Robin, hit that note, Robin. Let's go to another level. Help her shout. Help him dance. Help. You don't know how. Look at your neighbor and say, you don't know how much help I need right now. I feel like shaking my feet right now. I feel like throwing up my hand. What do you mean, the cause? The cause. Look at the scriptures in 2 Samuel 24.
In verse 24.
Hallelujah. I don't even know where I'm at. Where am I?
Somebody say 24. Did I put it up there? I'm all over the place. Where am I?
I'm gonna get tired of these slides after a while. Don't worry about putting it up. I can't find it. 2 Samuel 24 and 24. The Bible says, and the king said unto Arana, nay, but I will surely buy it of thee for a price. Neither will I offer burnt offering unto the Lord God, Lord my God, of that which cost me nothing. David was saying, I don't want nothing just freely given to me. Why? Because I understand if I don't pay the cost, I can't enjoy the worship. Come on, did you hear what the Holy Ghost just said? See, when you praise God and you ain't did nothing, your praise is empty. But when you can throw your hands up, knowing that tears had came down your face, knowing that your heart might have been broken, knowing that my God has always showed up just on time. See, when you throw up your hands and start dancing, guess what? Your praise got value. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, my praise has value. Come on, can you hit that no, Robin? And let somebody know my praise has value. Tell your neighbor, neighbor, my praise has value. You don't know the cause. You don't know what I've been through. But I want to tell somebody that my praise, it has a cause. It has some value. It has some sweet tears. What are you talking about, preacher? I'm getting ready to come in. Number three. I hope I got it up here. I don't know. I was working on this thing at 2:30 in the morning. That's probably why some of it's missing. All right, I don't know where it's at, but just listen to me. Number three, they were prepared for change. They were prepared for change. Number one, they were prepared for the journey. Number two, they were prepared with their gifts. And number three, they were prepared for a change. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, every time I come to church, I'm prepared for a change. Come on, give God a good praise right there. What are you talking about? Prepared for a change. The Bible says in Matthew 2 and 12, and I can't find it on this slide. I'll just leave it right there. Matthew 2 and 12 says, and being warned of God in a dream. What happened? What did it say? Being warned. Don't tell me God won't take you out of a situation and lead you out of a situation when he know you can't handle it. Stop begging to be dismissed. No class is in session. Woo! Look at your neighbor and say, stop running to the bathroom. You're going to have to take this test. Look what it says. And being warned of God in a dream that they should not return to Herod, they departed into their own country. What? Another way. Somebody say, another way. In other words, what are you trying to say here, preacher? What I'm trying to say here, they no longer follow the star. But now they were led by the Spirit. What are you talking about, preacher? They no longer was trying to figure out what Daniel was trying to teach. They now had a revelation. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, just like Job. Job said, I heard about it, the hearing of the ear. He said, but now I see it. Tell your neighbor, now I see it. I now see that God has never left me. I see that God has always been fighting my battle. I can see now when the enemy start running up, God was right there. He said, I'll fight for you. I'll stand for you. You will not be defeated. Because I'm a God that will fight for you. You ain't got to fight this one, Jehoshaphat. You stand back and give me glory. You stand back and dance. You stand back and shout. Because this enemy, they now understood what David was saying. What did David tell them? In Daniel 2 and 28, the Bible says, and there is a God in heaven. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, you ain't doing all this in vain. Come on, you ought to shout that on the rooftop. You ain't doing all this in vain. You ought to witness to your brother or sister and tell them you ain't doing this all in vain. God got a blessing with your name on it. God's got a blessing
with your name on it. Tell your neighbor, God's got a blessing with your name on it. Nobody gonna dish the line, cause what God got for you, nobody else can touch it. It's got to wait on you. God's got a blessing with your name on it. Somebody ought to break out and just start dancing. Somebody ought to just lift their hand and say, thank you, Jesus. Somebody ought to twist around in their seat. God got a blessing with your name on it. Tell your neighbor, you better go on and shout. You better go on and dance, because God got a blessing with your name on it. You said there's a God in heaven that reveals secrets. The devil won't get the upper hand, because God's going to let you know in advance just when to throw your hands up, just when to give me praise, because I'm not going to leave you alone. I'm going to be right there. I'm going to be a present help, because I'm willing for a change. God's got a blessing with your name on it. You ought to get loose in the Holy Ghost. God's got a blessing with your name on it. Now, since he's got your name on the blessing, you ought to put a praise on the blessing. Go on and give him praise. Woo! Woo! That's all right. I feel like I'm punch drunk. I feel like I'm loose in the Holy Ghost. God's got a blessing with my name on it. My name on it. My name on it. Somebody cut a mic on. She's helping me bless the Lord.
You're testing, testing. Testing, testing. Testing, testing. Whoa.
Oh, hallelujah! Thank you, God. I receive my blessing, God. I receive my miracle. Oh, man, my name. 'Cause you know my name, God. He knows my name. I'm gonna walk in my blessing. I'm gonna receive my blessing. Oh, I'm thankful. I'm grateful for my blessing.
Oh, because he knows. He knows. And he will make all things beautiful in his time. Oh, God, I thank you, Father. I thank you, God. I give you the glory. Lord, I magnify your name, God. Oh, because in due season, which is my fifth season, I shall reap, God. If I faint not, God, I'm going to praise you. I'm going to lift you up. I'm going to magnify your name. No matter what it looks like. No matter what it feels like. Oh, no matter what I got to go through, God. Because the end result is my blessing. With my name. With my name on it.
With my name on it. Oh, hallelujah.
Yes, yes.
Oh, hallelujah.
Oh, Lord.
Glory, glory.
I'm anticipating. I'm looking for a miracle. It's coming to me. It's coming, it's coming, it's coming. All the best is yet to come. The best is yet here. Oh, I'm positioning myself for my B-L-E-S-S-I-N-G S blessing.
Yeah. Oh.
Woo.
Oh, God.
Blessing with my name on it. Turn me up. Blessing with my name on it. Come on, testify to somebody. Blessing with my name on. Tell somebody else a blessing with my name on. Ain't been in vain, preacher. David, Daniel said there's a God in heaven that revealeth his secrets and maketh known to the king Nebuchadnezzar what shall be in the latter days. Thy dream. Tell your neighbor, hold on to your dream. And hold on to your visions. Daniel said to the king, thy dreams and thy visions upon thine bed shall come to pass. Shall come to pass. The weight in the situations, they all got value. I want to ask this question on tonight, this morning. Are you prepared for your journey? You've heard that they were prepared. And have you prepared the gifts of your heart to give it all to Jesus? What do you mean, give it all to Jesus? You've given so much of yourself to him that these things don't move you. See, that's what Paul was trying to get the saints to understand. That when you give everything to God, the enemy can't manipulate your emotions because you belong to God. I want to ask, have you been prepared for your life change? You come in one way, but each time you leave out from the presence of God, you leave out differently than you came. This is what this story of these three, these magi, brings to our understanding. That when you come to the altars of God, these are the things you should ponder. I'm ready to meet him. Every time you come, are you prepared to meet him? I pray that this message has been an encouragement and inspiration through the Holy Ghost to your life. I want to present Jesus Christ to someone today as your Lord and Savior, as the praise team comes up, as we close out this session. of worship. I want to present Jesus. Pastor, I heard your message today and I was so unprepared. First of all, I want you to know, Pastor, that I am not saved. But now that I've heard your message, I know that I can go to church all day and still not be prepared to meet you. And so today, I want to give my life to Jesus as Lord and Savior of my life. The Bible says if you truly believe in the confession and you confess it with your mouth, the Lord Jesus, thou shalt be saved. My prayer is, as you have given your life to Christ today, that you will find a church that's preaching the word of God and that the leaders of the house are living the life they preach. I pray that you'll be blessed. I pray that you will leave out this day another way. Another way in your lifestyle, another way in your behavior. You are now a new creature or creation in Christ Jesus. May God bless you. Heaven smile upon you. That is my prayer. Receive our praise team as we close.
Makes no difference what you're going through. You're gonna make it. God's gonna see you through. Hold your head up. Put a smile on your face. This is another test and it will last away. Get ready.
Get ready.
For your blessing.
For your blessing.
Get ready.
Get ready.
For your miracle.
For your miracle.
Get ready.
Get ready.
For your blessing.
For your blessing.
Get ready.
Get ready.
For your miracle.
Your miracle.
Listen. I know you've been hurting deep down inside, but let me encourage you, it's gonna be alright. Trial of the trials come to make you strong. Keep on believing and keep on holding on. Get ready.
Get ready.
For your blessing.
For your blessing.
Get ready.
Get ready.
For your miracle.
Your miracle.
Get ready.
Get ready.
For your blessing.
For your blessing.
Get ready.
Get ready.
For your miracle.
For your miracle.
God's got a blessing.
God's got a blessing.
I say God's got a blessing.
God's got a blessing.
Whoa, God's got a blessing.
God's got a blessing.
I say God's got a blessing.
God's got a blessing.
Put your name on it.
Name on
it. I say
God's got a blessing.
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 Put your name on it.
Put your name.
I say God's got a blessing.
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 Put your name on it.
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 Your name.
Look at somebody and say, "What's your name on it?"
Put your name on it.
Put your name on it.
Put your name on it.
God's got a blessing.
God's got a blessing.
Put your name on it.
Put your name on it.
Say God's got a blessing.
God's got a blessing.
Put your name on it.
Put your name on it.
Say God's got a blessing.
God's got a blessing.
Say God's got a blessing.
God's got a blessing.
Say God's got a blessing. God's got a blessing.
God's got a blessing.
God's got a blessing.
God's got a blessing.
With my name on it.
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 Yeah.
God's got a blessing.
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 He's got a blessing.
God's got a blessing.
He's got a blessing.
God's got a blessing.
I'm waiting on my blessing.
God's got a blessing.
I need just a pain on my blessing.
God's got a blessing.
I know he's gonna bless me.
God's got a blessing.
God's got a blessing.
God's got a blessing.
With my name on it.
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 With my name on it.